ياسين والقرآن الحكيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، أما بعد. We continue with the next verse of Surah Yasin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَن نُعَمِّرْهُ نُنَكِّسْهُ فِي الْخَلْقِ. The one who we have advanced in age, we diminish in structure. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَمَن نُعَمِّرْهُ, the one who we have lengthened their life, نُنَكِّسْهُ فِي الْخَلْقِ. You will see a diminishing factor in the structure of the body and even in their physical abilities. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, that as a human being, you are strong, you are healthy. And then when you have an advanced age, when Allah blesses you with a long life, you now see a clear diminish in your abilities, in your entire body, in your structure. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu alladhi khalaqakum min da'f. Allah created you from weakness when you were a baby. Then, ثُمَّ جَعَلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ضُعْفٍ قُوَّةٍ. After that, Allah gave you strength. You got to your youth, you got to a stage where a person is in his peak now. But after that, ثُمَّ جَعَلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ ضَعْفًا وَشَيْبًا. After that strength, still Allah takes you back to a stage of weakness and of old age. Then, that is what when a person becomes like a child again. So many times in old age, a person forgets, like how a child constantly asks the same questions. A person now doesn't have the physical ability. There are so many similarities between a child and a person in old age. That is why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to make dua that, oh Allah, protect us from the difficulties of old age. This is also a dua that we should make. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that do people not see that after having given them the strength, we then gave them the old age. And when the old age, the prolonged life came, you see a clear, weakness in the body. Allah says, after all of this year, do people, أَفَلَا يَعْقِلُونَ? Do people not ponder over this? What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us? Some of us say Allah is telling us that if you look at the world looks so powerful and beautiful. Don't forget, just like the human body that was once so beautiful and powerful, it comes gradually to a stage where it diminishes and it loses everything. The world will also go through that. So this world is not going to last forever. Thereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ شِعْرٌ, that we have not taught poetry to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ, and neither is it befitting of him. So what is it that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying? إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ, it is a reminder, وَقُرْآنٌ مُبِينٌ, and it is the clear Quran. Now, many of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum mentioned regarding Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not very in favor of poetry himself. So he wouldn't compile poetry. And at times, when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would quote the poetry of others, sometimes Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would quote it and then the words would get mixed up. Whereas in poetry, it is important for it to be in that sequence. So on one occasion, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu corrected Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the words of that poetry and said, oh Nabi of Allah, it is the other way around. But what did Allah teach us from this? The words that came out of the mouth of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were not poetry. What is Allah telling us? We did not teach Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam poetry. Neither is it befitting of him to learn poetry. So what is coming out of the mouth of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ, it is a reminder for you. وَقُرْآنٌ مُبِينٌ, don't ever doubt the Qur'an to be words of poetry. No way. It is nowhere near poetry. The words of the Qur'an are without doubt the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thereafter Allah tells us, now why are these words of the Qur'an? لِيُنْذِرَ مَنْ كَانَ حَيَّا. This Qur'an will be a reminder for who? You will be able to warn who? مَنْ كَانَ حَيَّا. Those who are alive. Those whose hearts are alive. Those who choose not to believe in Allah, what will be their result? وَيَحِقَّ الْقَوْلُ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ, and this will establish a proof against those who disbelieve. So they did not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran will now be a witness against them. Thereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا, do people not see, أَنَّا خَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ مِمَّا عَمِلَتْ أَيْدِينَا, do people not see that we have created for them, خَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ, we created for them, مَا مِمَّا عَمِلَتْ أَيْدِينَا, that which we created, Allah created, أَنْعَامًا, all of this cattle, فَهُمْ لَهَا مَالِكُونَ, and now people all own all of these cattle. So when people own these animals, this cattle,
They did not create them. Allah says, we created it ourselves and we gave it to man. So man had absolutely no say in the creation. Yet, فَهُمْ لَهَا مَالِكُونَ, they are the owners of it. Ownership, what do we learn from this? Ownership doesn't come from your capital. Ownership doesn't come from your labor. Ownership comes from Allah. Allah gives it to a person. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذَلَّلْنَاهَا لَهُمْ, we place them at the service of man. We made them, these animals, subservient to man. فَمِنْهَا رَكُوبُهُمْ, some of them they ride, rakiba, and وَمِنْهَا يَأْكُلُونَ, and some of them people eat. So, for example, horses we ride, camels we ride, some of them we eat. Camels can also be eaten, the cows, the sheep, etc. Those will be eaten. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is what we have done for man. And in this word, وَذَلَّلْنَاهَا, we have made it subservient to them. Look at how powerful and huge these animals are. Yet Allah made them subservient to us. You look at a young child, jumps onto a horse that is much stronger than the child. Yet Allah made that animal subservient to human beings. This is the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Till we meet again, we discuss further where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about his bounties. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.